Hey, Foot Clan. Today's episode is brought to you by Harry's Razors. And this holiday, Harry's is offering a limited edition shaving set. You get a midnight blue chrome razor handle, which you can get engraved with initials as a gift. Three of Harry's German-engineered five-blade cartridges, a foaming shave cream that smells amazing, and a beautifully designed gift box. Goes for $30 on Harry's. So go to harrys.com. Free shipping ends on December 9th. Go there now. Enter promo code FOOTBALLERS for $5 off.
Hey, this is Allen Robinson from the Jacksonville Jaguars, and you're listening to the Fantasy Footballers Podcast.
Welcome to the Fantasy Footballers Podcast, coming to you from the FantasyJocks.com studios with your hosts, Andy Holloway, Jason Moore, and Mike Wright.
Welcome in, welcome one and all to the show of shows. The Fantasy Footballers are back again.
Here we are.
What?
Here we are.
What in the world is going on with your body?
I'm just pumped, man. It's playoffs. It's time to get going. We got listener questions. We got a mailbag show today.
We got pump the brakes.
Oh, there's so much going on.
So much going on. I'm excited. It's going to be a great show. We're going to dive into so many different things. We've got some news and notes in the show today, catch you up on some interesting topics, and then we're going to dive right into the listener mailbag. A lot of these questions are, even if you weren't the one that submitted them, they're going to be very relevant to you.
Very pertinent.
Because these are, you know, we're on Twitter every day, at the FF Ballers. We're getting questions every day, and a lot of them sound the same. I had like six questions hit me this morning that all had Ladarius Green's name in them. It was Fedorowicz or Green. It was Fleener or Green. It was tons of those. So we're going to dive headfirst into that. It's going to be great. Make sure you check out Mike on Periscope Sunday morning before the games. It's always great to get last-minute questions in there as well. And check us out on the web, thefantasyfootballers.com. That's how these questions get submitted for the show. And like Jason said, we have pumped the brakes on the show today as well. So it's going to be a good one. What else do we have? We got some new articles up on the website, snap count observation article. If you want to see how snaps are breaking down on certain teams right now, that's always a good insight. Maybe help you decide which of a couple guys to play. But otherwise, I think we're ready. You guys ready?
I'm ready.
I was made for this.
O'Reilly.
O'Reilly.
Auto parts.
Ow! All right, pump the brakes with O'Reilly. Mike, who you pumping the brakes on?
I am pumping the brakes on a man coming off of a bye week. Mr. Marcus Mariota.
Really?
Mariota.
Now look, Mr. Auto start.
Yeah, he had fully turned into an auto start. I mean, he has been just tearing up the
He's
NFL.
Number four. I looked this morning. Rodgers is number one. Breeze is number one, tied with Rodgers. Matt Ryan, number three. Marcus Mariota, number four.
Exactly, and that's my point. He has turned into an auto start, but Denver. He's got the matchup with Denver, and to me, that's, you know, you have a guy like Tom Brady against Denver coming up. I'll probably still play Tom Brady against Denver. There are a couple quarterbacks that you will say, okay, I will eat this matchup because the quarterback has been so great. Marcus Mariota, to me, is not among that list. Zero touchdowns to Blake Bortles last week, one to Alex Smith the previous week. Only two games this season have they given up multiple passing touchdowns, Breeze and Rivers. Like I said, there's some quarterbacks where you overlook the matchup because you know that they are so solid. And I'm talking, I would play Carson Palmer. I would play my stream of the week, Carson Wentzylvania. I would play Jason's stream of the week, Trevor Siemian. These are guys.
Eli Manning?
Yes, Eli Manning. I would
Andy
play
Dalton.
Oh, yes.
Derek Carr.
Yes. Even Derek Carr. Terrible matchup for Derek Carr against the Chiefs. He was
225-1 last time against them.
He was abysmal against them for fantasy, but I would still start him over Marcus Mariota. That's how concerned I am for him.
This is the playoffs. And you're cutting.
We're not messing around.
You're cutting your knees off if you start Marcus Mariota because your upside is very limited. It would take an otherworldly game that doesn't match up with what Denver's given up over the past, 3 years for Mariota to give you that type of game-winning, fantasy-winning performance. So I like that pump the brakes.
Yeah. I think it's very good. I'll hitch on next here. My I can say anything I want.
Yeah, it's true.
I was like, my pump the brakes this week is Rashad Jennings.
Oh,
Rashad Jennings has been very good for fantasy owners over the last month. I have been one such owner where I've been very pleased with his production. Three out of the last 4 weeks, he's been well into double digits. This past week, in a half-point scoring, he basically had 15 fantasy points. That's great if I can get 15 fantasy points from, you know, kind of that running back who is not the star on my team. However, we need to be a little cautious here with how we think about Rashad Jennings, because last week he had 15 fantasy points. He only had six carries that game.
It was Paul Perkins' career high.
Yes. Paul Perkins seemed to take over. Now, Rashad Jennings was effective, got a touchdown in the passing game, and so his fantasy output was okay. But this week we've seen kind of Paul Perkins is eating into his workload. Now they go up against Dallas. This is the playoffs. And Dallas, for fantasy purposes, against running backs, they're the third best. They do not give up a lot of fantasy points to opposing running backs. So the combination of a bad matchup with a poor usage right now, or a trend that doesn't look appealing, I'm not saying you can't start him. I think right now I have Rashad Jennings ranked as my RB27. So you can if you have to, but this is the playoffs. And I sure hope I've got better than RB27 in my lineup. And I've been playing him the last few weeks. I'm sitting him this week.
All right. My pump the brakes is going to be a guy that scored in three of the last 4 weeks. And if you're chasing a wide receiver start, I say you do not chase Brashad Perryman right now. He was the number 13 wide receiver last week. But what you have to realize is this is on very limited total catches. I think when people are looking at Baltimore and seeing this New England game, they know they want to start somebody. Maybe they're coming. Maybe Baltimore's coming back. They're fighting in a higher scoring affair. I'd start. Here's the headline for me. I would start Steve Smith, Mike Wallace, and Dennis Pitta ahead of Rashad Perryman. I think
Pitta
and Pitta, even in the flex.
The one hip quitta?
Yeah, I just don't. I don't like a guy that is delivering all of his fantasy value on one or two catches a week. He's only had three catches in the last 2 weeks. It just so happens that two of them are touchdowns, and so too scary for me. The numbers look better than the player does. Doesn't mean he can't go Ted Ginn on me. I mean, 2 weeks ago, I pumped the brakes on Ted Ginn. He caught a bomb after Earl Thomas went out. It happens. But you're playing with fire with that. So, actually, that was this past week. But that is my pump the brakes. We got Mariota, Perryman, Jennings. That was pump the brakes with O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. Let's jump into some of the news.
News and notes from around the league.
Well,
we get to play it again.
I'm so happy. Joik Bell has re-signed with another team.
And this this sound, this audio that you're hearing, this is actually, this is retro. This is
this the original cut?
This is the original copy from because he's back with the Lions.
So, yeah, Joik Bell has re-signed with the Lions, who had cut Justin Forsett.
I think this is a sign that they're slightly concerned about Dwayne Washington.
Yeah. Yeah, no, you're right, because his injury. But Joik Bell's back, irrelevant for fantasy, but fun for music drops. Colin Kaepernick will be the starter for Week 14.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to say it. I told you guys yesterday I was going to say this on today's show.
Don't do it.
I know you told us. You warned us. I tried to get insurance against it.
I know, but I'm going to say this. I think Colin Kaepernick is a decent play this week. And I know, Andy, you disagree vehemently. And I want to say it this way. Okay, this is the reality, because we can't make bold claims in playoff weeks. We need to be as accurate as we can. My worry is that because how bad Colin Kaepernick was this last week, people are going to overreact. And they're going to say, well, he's a bum. You can't play him. You can't play him over anyone out there. The Jets have not shown up. Their defense, their whole team right now looks like a team that has quit on the season. And that's the matchup this week. Colin Kaepernick is named the starter. And so I just worry that people are going to overreact too much. I will say this. He is as risky as any quarterback out there. The risk might not be worth the reward, because the risk is he has a bad first quarter and he gets pulled. And so obviously if he had a bad first quarter, he's not scoring fantasy points for you there. And if he's pulled, he's not scoring fantasy points the rest of the game. So here's the team that I would say has a chance to start Colin Kaepernick, and really only in this situation. But if you're that last seed that got in the playoffs and you're matched up against the first seed, and that team's just flat better than yours, and you need a monster play, and you don't have a good quarterback, that's why you're the last seed, then a Colin Kaepernick's upside here, I think, is
far greater than Tyrod Taylor.
Sometimes.
Far greater than probably Alex Smith.
So, I mean, I've got Colin Kaepernick right now one spot ahead of Marcus Mariota, put it that way.
Yeah. Look, sometimes you put the nitro boosts in the car. Right?
Right. Exactly.
And sometimes your car goes way faster than everybody. Sometimes it explodes.
Yes, that is exactly. This is putting nitro boost in your fantasy lineup. Not always the best idea.
If you can, like, rub some Vaseline over your eyes and forget what you saw last week about Colin Kaepernick,
it burns.
Then, and you see the previous performances and you tell me that he's going to start, there's a reason we said pick him up for the playoffs originally. It's these matchups. I can't do it. I cannot do it.
Sure, I don't.
But
I don't.
Your analysis.
If you
is
hate,
correct.
If you hate, drop them. That's fine.
If I hate, yeah,
there
I
are
hate
other
them.
Options.
It's not just your eyes. I mean, your face went full on Raiders of the Lost Ark. Melt. You're gonna have to pick your face up off the ground and put it back together.
No, and I'm not letting him tear my face off again. All right, Jeremy Maclin is expected to play. He was a full participant in practice on Tuesday.
Boo!
Yeah, I know.
Is that
seriously.
A boo for Tyreek Hill owners?
That's a boo for Tyreek Hill owners.
Sorry,
a boo Maclin. For
it's good. It's good for the Smith stream.
Yes, it is good for Alex Smith. I think it's bad for Tyreek Hill a little. He's not the guy that I think it affects the most. I think it's Zeus.
Yeah,
Zeus, while Maclin has been out, has been the best tight end in the league.
3 of 4 games over 100 yards.
The hope. And weren't you telling me in Alex Smith's career?
Yeah, in Alex Smith's career, there has how many times has a pass catcher had 3 consecutive games over 100 yards? And the answer is Travis Kelce just did it.
Yeah, that was the first and only time. And so I think he does take a slight step back. The hope is that this newfound offensive weapon kind of stays that way.
I do not think in this Thursday matchup that you can bet on the kind of prototypical Kansas City Chief offensive win. I mean, where they can play conservative and they can rely on their defense. I mean, you have Oakland, who is 10-2, division leading, fighting. I know it's in Arrowhead, but they're going to score. This is what you've seen from Oakland this week, this year. They break through at some point. It might be the third quarter, it might be the fourth quarter, but they break through. So I'm hopeful for those that are, you know, looking at Kelce and Smith as a streamer, that you get enough out of them to be happy.
I will, and just to jump on there, like you said, the Raiders are 10-2. One of those two was the Chiefs.
Correct. So. Yeah. I mean, for those starting Derek Carr, what do we say? 225-1 last time they played?
Yeah.
With a pick or multiple picks? So this is the time for them to rise above, though. You're a 10-2 team. You want to show you're a contender. This is the division. Kansas City wins this. I think Kansas City wins the division. So,
fair.
All right. Anything else from the news category, guys?
There was the blurb about Rob Kelly.
Yeah.
Jay Gruden.
He's looked great.
Yeah, he's looked fantastic.
Other than trying to catch the ball.
That's like a seal.
Yeah. It's very comical to watch. They really go for
that. Rob Kelly's got to get that part of his game a little bit better. But Jay Gruden came out and said, quote, "There's no doubt about it. We would like to get more of Kelly involved." Now, I know I always make fun of the coaches when they say this because you're in charge, but it's just something to monitor that these matchups for Rob Kelly in the future are not strong, but
he ran well against Arizona.
He only got
14 carries.
Be in Philadelphia this week. Philadelphia's defense is softened.
Yeah, they
mostly
really have.
Because their secondary is softened and it's allowed running backs to make a little more hay. So let's go ahead and get in the mailbag.
Mailbag.
Oh, it's time for some playoff mailbag. Visit the website. Click the questions button if you want to submit questions for the show. You can also dial our voicemail hotline 302-464-TFFB. Please keep your questions on the voicemail short so we can play them on the show. And a reminder, we're doing all of our week 14 rankings, premium projections, flex rankings at jointhefoot.com. All that stuff is coming out today, so stay tuned for that. And we're going to answer some questions right now, starting with a voicemail question.
Ooh.
So let's go ahead and do that.
How's it going, guys? Huge fan of the show. Had a quick question. I lost Gronk, AJ Green, and Alshon Jeffrey off my team the same week.
Oh.
Killed me. I'm still in the hunt for the playoffs, but I have to win this week. I have Fedorowicz Antonio Gates. Who do I play this week? Thanks for the help, guys.
I play Fedorowicz. I do not have any confidence in which. It's not even a which right now, in terms of Gates or Henry, which one to play.
You were confusing me. She's a witch.
There's no witches out there. But last week, I think Gates had what?
She turned me into a newt.
Gates had a couple catches. Henry had one. I mean, for me, I'd play Fedorowicz.
And for me, I would go Gates. So, Mike, you're going to end up tie-breaking this. But I'll just say this. When it comes to Gates versus Fedorowicz, they're both going to catch four or five balls, in my opinion. I think Fedorowicz is going to have four or five. Gates is going to have four or five. This last game, Gates had four receptions. He was goosed in Houston before that. Four receptions, five receptions. That's what Gates has done. And I think Fedorowicz will be there. But if I have to bank on who's getting a touchdown, I think Gates is more likely than Fedorowicz. So I would lean Gates. They are back-to-back in my rankings.
Yeah, I mean, it's super close. You're right. I feel like, you know, Fedorowicz had the three touchdowns in a row, and he hasn't scored in four weeks.
Right.
So maybe he's due, but maybe it's Brock Osweiler. So if you had to bank on a quarterback, you'd bank on Rivers. Better chance of a huge game from Gates. There's no doubt about that.
I still would go Fedorowicz.
Okay. All right.
I stand alone.
You stand alone at the gates of Antonio. All right, let's go ahead and jump into this question from Gavin in Portland. Who would you rather handcuff, Zeke or the slippery fish?
Why not both?
Well,
there's a four running
back. He's trying to decide here.
So it's a four running back maximum. Has Zeke, Shady Gordon, and Alf. And I would rather handcuff the slippery fish. I feel like it's every other week. I'm sending a message to the guys on Slack. I'm saying, and LeSean McCoy's dead again.
Yeah, you're starting to get into a boy cried wolf situation with that one.
Right.
Because we see that note, and I'm like, oh, really? How bad is he hurt? And then, like, you go.
He's done for the season.
He had a really nice run.
Oh, he's back in.
No, you had the couple weeks ago where, I mean, he got clipped low. He went down. Helmet came off immediately.
Yeah.
An entire herd of training staff rushed on the field, and everyone was, oh,
It looked season ending.
And then he got help to the side, and he said, whoa, I just got to warm up real quick. And then last week, you had the play where he goes down. I mean, it obviously was the muscle cramps, but he lays there with his legs stuck straight in the air. You're like, oh, crap, here we go again.
But you're right. Gillislee's already making a mark with McCoy. If McCoy went down, Gillislee would be, I think the odds of McCoy going down are just higher than
that. And that's
exactly
why.
That's all it is.
Yeah, Alf, I think, is the higher play if both guys went down, but I would much rather be protecting Shady right now.
All right, Christian in El Paso says, who would you rather start? Malcolm Mitchell.
All right.
Demaryius Thomas or Stephen Diggs.
This is a PPR.
Demaryius Thomas has Tennessee.
Yeah, that
Diggs has Jacksonville.
The matchup of Demaryius Thomas against the Tennessee Titans secondary is delightful. I mean, there's no other way to put it. The Tennessee secondary has been just abysmal, giving up, three touchdowns in week 12. Wasn't last week, but to Chicago. That was the comeback attempt there by Barkley to the previous week. I mean, just if you look at the what they're actually giving up in total fantasy production to the wide receiver, it's horrifying. So that's where I would lean, assuming that Trevor Siemian is the quarterback.
I am with you. I'm going to Demaryius Thomas. The over-under on all these games is pretty low, all three players. The Minnesota game, my worry is that Jacksonville just won't be able to do a thing against that Minnesota defense. They haven't been able to do a thing lately at all. And so the Stephen Diggs PPR play there, I don't mind it.
Right.
I would go Thomas, Diggs, Mitchell in this set.
Okay, so Mitchell is your three?
He is.
Okay. Is Mitchell your three, Jason?
Mitchell would be my three, but he's so close to me. I mean, the way that I see it is very similar to what Andy's describing. Mitchell has a higher ceiling than Diggs to me because I don't see Minnesota needing a lot of offense, whereas, you know, Mitchell could explode. But Diggs seems very safe. So, but the answer for me, it's unanimous for us. It's Demaryius Thomas.
Well, and what if the Tampa Bay Buccaneer mascot is the quarterback, Paxton Lynch? What if he's the QB for Thomas? Is that change your answer?
Yes, it does.
It does for me, yeah. I would go Diggs at that point.
All right. I would go Mitchell at that point.
All right, Luke in New Jersey wants to know this. That's not the same question there. Okay, there we go. Luke in New Jersey. Who should I start in my flex? By the way, this is what I'm talking about. Everybody's got Malcolm Mitchell in there. Malcolm Mitchell, LeGarrette Blount, or Allen Robinson? Malcolm Mitchell, LeGarrette Blount, or Allen Robinson? This is a standard, league. I'm going Blount.
Yeah, you got to go Blount here. Baltimore has a very good defense, and so you can worry about that. But it's not like, I mean, Malcolm Mitchell's playing against a bad defense. Allen Robinson's playing against a bad defense. LeGarrette Blount is in standard. He's scoring touchdowns. He's been used. I'm definitely sticking with Blount.
I got Blount.
When you say bad defense, you meant like a good defense?
A bad matchup.
Bad
good
matchup.
Defense.
Gotcha.
I've got Blount at the beginning, Allen Robinson at the back, so that puts Malcolm in the Mitchell.
You've been trying to set that one up for weeks. All right. Before we get into this next question from Garrett in Chicago, I do want to thank today's sponsor. You know them. I love them. 5-4 Club. The 5-4 Club, look, it's a monthly clothing club. For $60 a month, you get hooked up with incredible quality, amazing clothes. I've been using them forever, and here's the deal. They're not just a monthly club. When you have access to the club, you get access to their store at massive discounts. This past week, I was raving about how much I love their jeans. I went on there. I bought 3 new pairs of jeans, bunch of shirts, some Henleys, things like that. I got it all at a crazy discount, like $30 for jeans. And these jeans are more comfortable than almost anything I have. So you've got to get connected with them. You get proven style authors showing you what to wear as opposed to me trying to figure it out on my own. And so if you're curious about how easy the 5-4 Club really is, go to 5-4club.com, use the promo code BALLERS. At sign up, you get 40% off your first month. And so you get to check them out, and they're going to send you some Mark McNary sunglasses for free as well, which is valued at $75. So that's 54club.com, the promo code BALLERS. That offer expires on December 31st, so get in there now, 54club.com, promo code BALLERS.
We also want to thank Blue Apron. Blue Apron, they are making dinner time easier. They are making dinner time a lot more fun because they are shipping you delightful recipes right to your door. You don't have to think about, well, what am I going to make? Blue Apron's taking care of it because a box of goodies is coming right to you. And look, they're fantastic things with the environment. I'm talking the beef is raised humanely. Chickens are free range. The pork is raised naturally. They use regenerative farming practices. So look, they're thinking about the big picture here at Blue Apron. And we know that cooking together builds stronger families. Check out some of these meals on the docket this month. Roasted pork and braised cabbage with barley and glazed apples. Thai green coconut curry with sweet potato and jasmine rice. Brown butter with chestnut gnocchi with Brussels sprouts and pea shoot salad. I'm talking delicious gourmet meals.
I love food.
So check out this week's menu. Get your first 3 meals free with free shipping by going to blueapron.com/ballers. You will love how good it feels and tastes to create incredible home-cooked meals with Blue Apron. So don't wait. That's blueapron.com/ballers. Blue Apron, a better way to cook.
All right, let's get back into this question from Garrett. I will say this. Apparently, all of our sponsors just allow us to be freed up to study fantasy football even more. So all of you players out there, hey, we'll dress you. We'll feed you.
Yes.
And you can enjoy the football and your family. So Garrett has a question. He says, who should I pick up to handcuff with Carlos Hyde? Would you pick up DeJuan Harris or Shondron?
That's actually, I mean,
it's DeJuan Harris.
Yeah, it's not even close.
Well, Shondron's been playing fantastic.
But this is one of those things where it's like, it was like a couple years ago in Dallas where it was, who's the scat back in Dallas? Lance Dunbar.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to handcuff with Lance Dunbar because Darren McFadden would have been the guy to take the cake. To me, it's the same situation. DeJuan Harris is the...
You saw last year with the Saints, right? I mean, Tim Hightower wasn't the guy playing when Ingram was there. He was the handcuff once Ingram was gone. You see it with Cameron Artis Payne last year as well.
Oh, yeah,
he wasn't even active in the game, but he is the handcuff. Harris is the handcuff here.
All right, here's a question from Sam in Miami. Is it best to watch out for the weather for kickers who might play in snow?
Yeah,
he has Gostkowski, doesn't know how. Yeah, yes.
Weather is oftentimes overreacted to. There are only 2 things that really matter in weather. One is the main one is wind. Wind is what matters. Like, it doesn't matter whether it's hot or cold. I was doing research this week on temperature as we get into this time of year. Going back historically, if you look back at the last 5,000 games and you take weather into account, you look at the total points scored in the game, weather temperature makes no difference. Makes virtually no difference.
Unless it's Colin Kaepernick versus Matt Barkley.
Well, what happens is when it gets to the 20s, when it gets to the 20s and below, it affects the passing game. The passing game goes to crap, but the running game goes up. Total points is still very good. However, with kickers, that's where...
There's just no need to play a kicker in a bad situation like that. The only one that I would consider just not paying attention to at all is Justin Tucker. Because he hasn't missed a kick all year, and they give him opportunities from beyond the 50, and it's not going to cost you to get those. Otherwise,
I really want him.
I love dome games this time of year for kickers.
Yes. I really just want Justin Tucker to be in a position at the end of a game. There's 1 second on the clock. They're not worried. Tie game, and they're like, we're going to go for the 70-yard field goal. Just try it. Because he'll nail that sucker. I know he will.
He definitely could break the 64-yard record.
For sure, if given the opportunity.
Yeah, as long as it's not in the snow. I don't think he's going to do it in the snow. All right, Jess in Sacramento has Aaron Rodgers as the only QB and has the Seahawks defense. Should they stream the Seahawks DST this week?
Oof.
That is a pickle. That is tough. You hate having your defense take a shot every time your quarterback performs. Seattle's 2.5-point favorites in Green Bay.
You are capping your upside, right? Because if Aaron Rodgers has a really good game, that means your defense sucks. And if your defense scores a lot and has a really good game, that means your quarterback probably didn't do as well.
To me, this is depending on who you can stream.
Right.
Because if you don't have a really good other option to stream, you're better off just taking the defense that's going to give you some sacks on Aaron Rodgers. That's probably not going to give up, 30-plus points. And
Earl Thomas is gone.
I like Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, that matters a lot.
I like Aaron Rodgers. I'm not really afraid of this matchup.
He's number one.
The question to me is whether or not there's, a defense that you can go pick up. Like the Lions. I love the Lions defense this week. They're available on almost all waivers. I would rather play the Lions
with Aaron Rodgers.
I'm not playing the Lions over Seattle in general. But if I've got Aaron Rodgers and I don't want to cap my upside, I'd be happy to do that.
All right. Jess in Mission Viejo.
So many Jesses.
Yeah, back-to-back Jesses. Standard League. Do I start Blunt versus Baltimore's number one ranked run D, or Brandon Marshall versus San Francisco's mess of a pass D? Standard League, I'm going to play Blunt.
Oh, man.
I can tell you right now, the hardest player that I'm coming to terms with in my rankings as I've been looking at this week is Brandon Marshall. I want to tell you that you can cut the guy, but I often make him my decision as to who I'm starting in all these questions.
Here's the problem. Ravens are number two against the run, fantasy points given up. And to me, this is just the touchdown factor. This is something I think New England can overcome against them. The last five games, they haven't given up a touchdown to running backs, but they have given up 12, 12 and a half, 20, 20, and 16 fantasy points. So they are giving up points and carries. It's just, to me, Blunt is just safer. I don't know what in the world's going to... I don't know if Robbie Anderson's going to get 37 targets in this game.
You do.
I do know that he will.
Yes, he will.
Well, see, but we could be wrong.
All deep.
We could be wrong. Marshall could, get his in four catches.
Yeah, I play Blunt.
What is your call, Jay?
I think I do go Blunt here.
with utmost confidence.
Well, the problem with me is
so much.
Blunt to me is an RB2 this week. I don't see him as a must start. He's an RB2. Brandon Marshall is the problem, and I don't trust Bryce Petty. He's just got such a juicy matchup against San Francisco that Brandon Marshall could exploit it. I don't trust Bryce Petty, and so I'm going LeGarrette Blunt unhappily.
Yeah. All right. Playoff quarterback question from Johnny in Philly. Playoffs are here. I took your advice, and I stashed Jameis Winston about 8 weeks ago.
Nice.
Did we give that advice 8 weeks ago?
We did.
I did.
Wow. However, I have Andrew Luck as my QB1. Should I be playing Jameis Winston because of the great matchups or stay in the flames and play Luck? Thank you for your help. For context, Andrew Luck is taking on Houston's defense.
I will say this.
Winston has New Orleans.
my Jameis Winston stash was not for Andrew Luck owners.
Right.
However, I mean, you got him. It's all right. You're keeping him away from your opponent. That's fine. It's still Andrew Luck.
Yes.
I'm gonna play in the playoffs. I'm playing my best guy. And that's Andrew Luck.
Andrew Luck had protection this last week. I mean, I know the Jets didn't show up, but they do have a good D-line. They didn't get through to him quite as often as we've seen. Houston, we don't know if Jadeveon Clowney will actually be there in the game.
Game's in Indianapolis.
T.Y. Yeah. Hilton is a Texan destroyer. I'm saying historically, if you go back and look at his numbers against Houston.
That's the name of his boat.
Texan
destroyer.
So it's maybe you're judging the future off of a bad past here, whatever. But I'm leaning with Andrew Luck and T.Y. Hilton to have big games.
All right. Cameron in Buffalo, New York.
Which New York?
City.
New York City.
Okay. I thought I was just going to get that from you.
Well, you got to say the city part in order to have that. I mean,
that's my fault, guys.
Buffalo.
Hey, guess what, guys? Question on Malcolm.
Albany.
Missed the boat in Malcolm Mitchell.
The Texan destroyer.
Yeah, missed the boat.
Missed T.Y.'s boat.
Best upside wide receiver three play this week from these guys.
All right.
Marvin Jones, Travis Benjamin, Tyler Boyd.
Oh, no.
Interesting.
Tyler Boyd for me. Marvin Jones, the health and everything is just... The health plus non-production puts me off of Marvin Jones. And Tyler Boyd...
Cleveland. Tyler Boyd with Cleveland, maybe a couple of those touchdowns will go his way.
Yes, the matchup is great. Benjamin, he had that almost out for the season knee injury.
Had a bad drop last week, too.
Well, I'm not going to hold... Everyone gets a bad drop every once in a while, but I would still go with Tyler Boyd against the Browns.
Yeah, I think I would as well.
All right. We answered the weather question, so I'm going to skip this one. They were asking how much does weather affect the games. I will say this. We'll give you weather updates for the matchups tomorrow and Friday when we go through the matchups. We'll let you know what they're projecting and give you some resources to find out on Sunday morning. We have a weather article that comes out on Sunday morning. So, last minute kicker switches or defense switches. You know, sometimes if a game is going to be, you know, a snowball, grab one of those defenses because not a lot's going to happen. All right, this question comes from Ty Cody, or maybe Ty and Cody, in Kentucky. Kentucky. Hey, FF Ballers, in my league, our commissioner traded away his whole team.
What?
To the second best team in the league in order to beat mine.
What?
The sad thing is no one is taking my side because they blame it on my team. I have the entire first round, who I traded for legitimately, on my roster.
I'm so confused by this question.
What? This is complete and utter nonsense.
I'm so confused.
If you're in a league where everyone is okay with the commissioner trading his second best team to your opponent.
His team's so good.
Because your team is good? You need a new league, brah. I mean, that's just stupid. That's nonsensical.
That is collusion.
That is league-wide collusion.
Yes.
Oh, man, I had a someone...
Here's what you do, though. Just throwing this out there. You beat the tar out of that team this week, and you laugh in
and
their
you walk
face,
into the
you
sunset.
You drop the mic. I had a listener tweet at me, said, check this out. Of course, it's the commissioner. He had played Inman this past weekend. And there was a screenshot of it with Inman in the game. All of a sudden, Tyrell Williams magically made his way into the lineup because that's what he meant to do. I was like, are you got to be kidding me? Why are people doing this?
If I could do the I meant to do thing, Colin Kaepernick might not have been hate dropped.
Yeah.
There's just...
No.
It's so ridiculous what commissioners are doing out there, and it makes me upset. It makes me sad
but
in my heart and my soul.
Let me read this next question because it'll help lead into the answer. Garrett in Alberta, Canada. Just wondering the best place to get into a keeper league with Foot Clan members. Hear you guys talking about the leagues all the time, wondering how to get involved.
FootClanLeagues.com is kind of a forum for all of our JoinTheFoot.com supporters. So if you sign up at JoinTheFoot.com, then you'll have access to the FootClanLeagues.com. That way, you know that everybody that has access to that is a legitimate, you know.
If somebody's supporting this show, they listen and they know enough about fantasy football to be committed. Like, we don't play in money leagues. Like, I know a ton of people do. Like, we don't play.
I have one.
Yeah, okay.
I have one, but it's
our main league is not a money league. Is
correct.
My point. But we have often talked about the fact that even having some investment in the league just kind of pushes people to legitimacy a little bit. That's what you get with the investment of people in the Foot Clan leagues, because they're people that are committed to the show and to, you know, everybody that played in them this year loved it.
Yeah.
And what's really neat is you get in there, you can just go to jointhefoot.com, stay with us all off season and start joining leagues early. I mean, like, people start putting them together in February. Go to jointhefoot.com and do that. And you get access to not just, joining random keeper leagues with people around the country. People set up local leagues.
Yep.
On the forums. They set up, like, okay, anybody in Ohio that we want to play together. So that's what we've been trying to facilitate is, you know, the game is more than the score. It's the people you play with. You got to enjoy what you're doing.
The camaraderie and the fun.
Or as opposed to league-wide collusion. That makes you want to pull your hair
but
out.
But your team's good.
Your team's good, so we're cool with it. As long as you lose. Weird.
People.
Weird. All right. Matthew Hunter in Canton, New York. I'm a local patron.
Local?
Oh, sorry. I'm a loyal patron of $5 a month.
Appreciate that, Matthew.
So a Foot Clan member. I own Winston, Evans, and Brait.
Ooh.
In a full PPR league, should I start them all going forward through the playoffs? Or, alternative, am I absolutely insane?
You are not absolutely insane. I don't know that I love going full Tampa Bay. You never go full Tampa Bay. I'm not. It's not crazy because the schedule's so good. You have the Saints,
the
twice,
Dallas,
and you have the Cowboys, who they are beatable. You can put some points on them. But
I got a question for you. Would you rather start those three? Or what if you replace Brait with Doug Martin? Would you feel more comfortable with Winston, Evans, Martin or Winston, Evans, Brait?
Ooh. If I'm starting him through the run, probably Brait, in the sense that Dallas is very good against running backs, but they've been susceptible to tight ends.
The Saints, so
you're saying if you're starting him through
all three
Saints,
weeks.
Dallas Saints.
Yeah.
The Saints have been better against the run lately, but I'm okay with it. I'm running, you know, the Winston Martin stack currently, so
I don't have a problem with it.
Yeah, I don't have a problem with it. I'm not. It's not crazy. I'll say that.
The odds of Evans or Brait receiving the end zone targets from Winston are so
would
high.
Would you pivot if possible? I mean, today was waivers. He's probably picked up, but would you pivot from Brait to Ladarius Green just to diversify a little bit?
Yes, I would. Yep. Jason, would you?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine doing that.
Here's the thing.
I feel like
let me give the counter argument. Mike just played on Monday night, lost by 0.1 points.
Thanks, Andy.
I'm just reminding.
Thank you.
Part of the problem was in that game. All right, T.Y. Hilton. He put up big yardage numbers, but you know, here and there a game comes along. Dwayne Allen catches three touchdowns. Moncrief catches the fourth. Hilton doesn't get any of them. What if it's Shepard and Martin for the two touchdowns for Tampa? Your team's buried because Winston doesn't throw any and you have no receiving touchdowns.
Sure.
That's the thing that does happen.
Yeah, I get the argument. And I would say this. Green is a good enough counterpart. He's about the only guy that would be waiver. Like, I wouldn't do Fedorowicz, but Green, I would diversify with him.
Would you wear a Fedorowicz?
Oh, of course.
Like in the winter?
A nice red Fedorowicz.
Yeah.
Would you, Spencer, wear a Fedorowicz?
I feel like they must sell Fedorowiczes in Russia.
No, they have the
I know, but
they
that,
have the big fuzzy hats. I don't know what they're called though.
The Fedorowiczes. Tight ends question.
We are uneducated.
No, we're not very smart. do I play Ladarius Green over Delanie Walker?
Ooh,
Delanie has a terrible matchup. Ladarius is looking like a beast.
Ooh,
that's his commentary.
That's a really good question. Now, I don't think Delanie Walker has as terrible a matchup as you think. I mean, I get that saying that. It's Denver. Denver has been one of the best defenses over the last several years, but they are completely middle of the pack against tight ends for fantasy. Right now they're 14th. With that, I think coming off the bye, healthy, they're going to need Delanie Walker in this game, and I still lean Walker.
I lean Walker as well. It's a half-point league.
Oh,
Walker
man.
Has shown a propensity for putting up big yeah. games. If he was just a Fedorowicz type of performer, I'd be going green, but Walker has put up those touchdown games.
I will say this. I don't see Walker. I think Green actually has the higher upside play because I don't see Walker going, you know, 80-2 against Denver. But I do see Walker.
You don't see him going Texas Ranger?
No. Walker, Texas Ranger.
The puns are out of control today.
Dad jokes.
I love it.
Yeah, so that's all I had to say.
All right.
Doug. In Texas, in a keeper league, should teams that don't make the playoffs be able to grab guys off of waivers or free agency?
Yes. 100%. The game is not ended.
But now, what if I want them?
Yeah, that's the whole thing. Well, okay. you're not actually competing. Well, too bad.
Let me ask you a different question, because in our league, we have consolation brackets for the 4-5 seed. We have you could get wet if you are the worst team in the league. There are things that happen sometimes for – after the playoffs. We're also a keeper league, so of course you keep waivers open for everyone. But let's say there is absolutely nothing that you are even able to play for. It is not a keeper league. You're not even in a consolation bracket. Your season is over. Why at that point would you allow it, other than their only goal at all would just be to be a jerk to whoever's still in the playoffs?
Because it's an even playing field for the whole season. You don't have, you know, it seems strange to me to have a competition on waivers for 10 to 12 weeks, and then now four teams get to compete on waivers.
No, I think that's a good answer, because I'm in agreement. That was more devil's advocate.
Sure, sure.
And I wanted to see if we actually had a good reason for the...
Well, and in my money league, we have a... top points of the week always gets a prize. So there's incentive for everybody to keep playing.
That's
even
cool.
If your team is just trash and you're out of the playoffs weeks ago, you still keep playing because you can get a small prize every week.
And since we're on this topic, I'm just saying, if there is nothing to play for in the league you're in, like when you're out, there's no consolation bracket, there's no prizes, there's no punishments, there's no nothing – fix that.
Yeah,
fix that
something.
For next season.
Here's a crazy question. Would you be in favor of a league that awards $5 Fab for the highest points per week?
Heck yeah. That's awesome.
No.
No?
No.
Giving kind of, you're rewarding
I'm not making the strong stronger.
Because you'd be making, it's not giving them cash, it's giving them like an advantage in the game.
Yes. Yeah, this is outside of the game.
That's a good point, that it does make the strong stronger.
Like,
I just kind of
have unlimited fab and my team is so good.
just popped into my head.
It's fun.
It's not. I like the train of thought, though.
All right, last question. Steven, St. Petersburg, Florida. Lots of wide receiver 2 and 3 options on waivers all season. Is it a viable strategy to take one early wide receiver, then lots of running backs, and then blow off all else until late in the draft? Is that a takeaway from this season? Great question, Steve. It's a great question to lead us into some of the offseason discussion, too. Look, if you listen to us before the season, I did not buy into the super amazing wide receiver, draft them all early. I am a running back guy.
One of our tips that we've given the last 2 years, even this year while it was so running back heavy, or I'm sorry, wide receiver heavy, is at the end of the draft, we will never have more wide receivers than running backs on our roster. You really don't need more than...
Four
is like that.
If you're playing in a 3-wide receiver, it's a little bit different.
Sure. But yeah, I mean, 4 is pretty much what I have on almost all of my roster. Sometimes I would be fine even with 3. However, to speak to your specific strategy of 1 early and then waiting, I probably won't do that. And the reason why is because at the draft, and this is probably a little too early to talk about, the goal here is that you know more than the other people, that you've got a couple really good targets. And so while you might... If you look at the end of the year, one stud, absolute home run at wide receiver, and then you've got studs at running back, you're going to be fine because you could stream that second wide receiver. But you can – I mean, look at this year. T.Y. Hilton is a perfect example. You could get him in the 4th round.
He's the number 6 wide receiver right now.
Right. So you could have got him in the fourth round. You just you got to play round by round strategy. We don't like locking yourself into
specific. That's true. But just some context: Jameson Crowder, Michael Thomas, Devontae Adams, Terrell Pryor, Tyrell Williams. These are all guys near the top of the wide receiver, you know, top 24 list that were obviously not those frontline guys that you could get. Even Larry Fitzgerald. I mean, Larry Fitzgerald is he's right behind T.Y. Hilton.
Almost always
dismissed again.
Almost always on my rosters, there's like seven running backs to and four wide receivers.
Yeah. So, all right, we're going to, I forgot, we got to preview the Thursday night football game.
See, it's easy to forget.
But see, I left some margin in my time here, Mike. We've got time to talk about it. All right, the 10-2 Oakland Raiders head to Arrowhead in Kansas City and take on the Chiefs, who are 9-3, 46.5 point over under. Chiefs are favored by 3 points at home. I can't wait to play in this game. I'm going to be playing. I'm going to start right end, defensive end for a play. No, I can't wait to watch this game. It's going to be 23 degrees outside, clear night. The car is in drive this year.
Yeah, it is.
Latavius Murray is on fire right now. I can't see any question about starting Carr or Murray.
I see questions about starting Carr.
I do.
I definitely do. I think in this very cold weather game for a very important game for Kansas City at home.
You said under 20 degrees. It's 23.
No, I said in the 20s.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying for the passing game.
Check the tape.
The passing game, I don't, you know, when it comes to over-under, it doesn't mean I'm taking the under. It just means I think that your Spencer Ware and your Latavius Murray might be better plays than your Tyreek Hill, Jeremy Maclin.
Than the passing game.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not telling you to sit Crabtree or Cooper. Those guys are just great targets with targets.
The Chiefs are an interesting defense. And obviously getting Justin Houston back, the play of Eric Berry has been great. But they've been scoring, okay? That's been the big thing about them. They've had touchdowns in three of their last four games. They still gave up, you know, 28, 27 points. I just think that Oakland's going to be able to do enough to make this game not a complete devastation for Derek Carr.
Sure. In the breakdown here that I want to kind of just point out, I'm not benching Michael Crabtree, but you're going to have to adjust, I think, the expectations for Crabtree over the season. You know, it's Crabtree is just a target monster. And we had the question earlier that said, not from today, but earlier last week, said, why does Derek Carr hate Amari Cooper? I think Derek Carr might love Amari Cooper this particular week. With Crabtree, he should see a lot of Marcus Peters in this matchup, and Peters is a very solid cornerback. So if I have Crabtree, I'm still going to play him, but maybe I adjust my flex to a guy that I know is a little more nitro.
My favorite play in this game is Ware, by the way. I think Ware is my favorite start of this
game. All right.
Yeah,
Raiders defense giving up 1.3 rushing touchdowns per game, the positive regression of Ware last week. Ware is a solid start.
I completely agree. I still think, even though everything I said with Jeremy Mack coming back, I'm still also very happy to have Travis Kelce.
Sure.
But going back to what you were saying, Mike, you think Marcus Peters will be on Crabtree, not on Cooper?
Yes. I think Crabtree will see more Peters than Cooper.
I think that makes Cooper a decent play if you're right, but that's hard to know.
Wide receiver wise, if you're having to pick one to start for Kansas City, Maclin, Tyreek, the Freak, or Wilson. Wilson had a monster week last week.
Wow. Well, on a fake punt.
Yeah.
That's not a
no.
You can count on that.
Maclin or Tyreek?
Tyreek.
I think I lean towards Tyreek as well because he has the upside for that 80-yard touchdown play, that single play that will get it done for you. When Maclin was healthy this year, he played in seven or eight games. I think he had three double-digit games.
He was around, in his time when he was healthy, he was around wide receiver 50 or so.
Yeah, I mean, not inspiring.
No, thank you.
It should be a very entertaining game. I'm excited. I'm a big Raider fan this year. Black Jack Del Rio. I'm enjoying that. And I'm a big Chiefs fan, too, because I feel like they've gotten it done on the back of a really great coach and a lot of discipline.
Who do you think wins the game?
Sounds like Sophie's choice right here.
Who do you think wins the game? I think Kansas City wins the game.
Yeah, I got him too.
All right. Reminder, thanks to 5-4 Club for sponsoring us today. If you don't have time to shop, you hate shopping.
And I do.
Let 5-4 Club handle making you look good. Go to 5-4club.com. Use the promo code BALLERS.
BALLERS.
At sign up and get 40% off your first month worth of 5-4 Club packages, as well as some free Mark McNary sunglasses valued at $75. The offer expires on December 31st. Thank you for joining us on the show today. Head over, you know, if you're not subscribed on iTunes, click that subscribe button.
It's real easy.
Leave us a review. Yeah, it's free. You just
go,
click it.
You go boop.
Hey, who doesn't like clicking a button? Honestly, it's so satisfying.
I'm more like tapping.
Tapping a button.
Yeah, there's not much click anymore.
Yeah. Got to bring that click back.
Ooh.
All right. Thanks for listening. We'll be back with matchups tomorrow. Starts of the week. The fantasy forecast. Lots of good stuff. Thanks for tuning in. And definitely check out FantasyJocks.com. FantasyJocks.com.
Yeah.
Use the promo code FOOTBALLERS to get trophies for your league. They have championship rings. It's awesome.
Belts.
So check them out.
Goodbye.
Thank you for listening to another episode of the Fantasy Footballers Podcast. Join our fantasy football community on jointhefoot.com and follow us on Twitter @TheFFBallers.